What's up, everybody? Dave Bartosiak here, and I've got another chart of the day. This time, we are talking Tesla. Papa Elon, speak to me, baby. Man, this has been a crazy ride for Tesla. Now, I just want to point out that we have this as his X rank number 5 strong sell right now because the analysts have been pushing those numbers to the downside. But we're just talking charts here. So I've got a few key areas we're going to look at. So that the April 24 lows, the December 24 highs, and then the 2025 lows, and then what's transpired since then. So we've got some broad strokes here on the chart. I want to dig in a little bit more. Let's draw some fibs. And this first fib, I'm not going to get super precise on. And I know you guys know how to do that, where you can click in here and put the exact levels. But I just want this for sort of eyeballs purposes. From 141 to the highs. Okay. Now I'm going to delete my lines I had here. And we're going to zoom in a little bit. So if you notice the move from those 23 lows to the 24 highs, as it started to retrace, look at how some of these levels interacted with the stock's price. Pretty remarkable stuff. But the most remarkable to me is that it retraced 78.6% of that move before it really found some strength. And since then, there's been some buyers here. So I want to clue in on these buyers. And we can pull that fib back off because this is going to be a little bit more relevant, I believe, is the most recent action. To give you an idea of, you know, if this does stall out, is it stalling out here? And then I guess, you know, why not go ahead and put this back here? So you could point out one thing that you can see here is that the move so far off of these lows matches up right now with that 38.2% retracement. So this is a key level. Sort of this 355 and change area is definitely an area where there has been some resistance. Now, if it goes through, then that's when we can talk about what some of these support levels are. So let's go back and take this one back off. All right. So if we are in fact stalling out, and you do have an RSI now that is a little bit overbought, was overbought, and now dip down through that 70 level, that's a bearish sign, okay? If this, in fact, is a top, and I know the market is a little bit exasperated here after just its incredible move off the April lows, plus you get the downgrade from Moody's. So yesterday, they bought the dip, but today, you know, looks like we're intraday. We gapped up on Tesla, but intraday, there's been some downside action. And here we are on Tuesday, May 20th. So it's retracing a bit, right? And we're seeing that right now, but we don't know where it will go. 322, if it continues to dip, is sort of your next level. That's going to be a weaker one. 301.90 is going to be much stronger. And if you notice, we do have a little bit of a gap here. We had a gap up from May 9th up until the 12th. So over the weekend, you had a little gap up, but we know the gaps love to get filled. So that could potentially be a level there. Like I said, that basically 300 and change level over there is where we're seeing a lot of potential support for Tesla shares coming on back down. Okay, so that's sort of the smaller picture, the more in tight view. But still, if you're looking more broad strokes, you do still have this 200 day that the stock finally jumped on over. And it also looks like you're going to get a golden cross here relatively soon. Looks like basically June as that 50-day continues to tick on up. And that's assuming that the price can stay up. If it rolls over, then you're going to get a situation where this sort of flattens out along with that 200-day if it rolls over. But like we were talking about in the fib analysis, is that sort of that just a bit over 300 level would be a great place to get in and buy. The 200 day is going to be right around there as well. So it's hard for folks to jump in on a stock when it's gone from 225 to 346 in such short order. Patience is rewarded, right? And, you know, this is Tesla. You don't have to trade Tesla, but if you're looking for a setup on this specific stock, I think waiting for a retest of 300 would make you feel a little bit calmer. versus jumping up here on a level that you know has been fib resistance. You know you had some resistance earlier in the year there. It can make for a little bit of nerve-wracking time. Plus, you have the same level, you have a consolidation in November. So you know that there's a lot of action that's taking place in this like 340 to 370 range. So if you're a little bit patient, I think it can make for a less stress kind of a day for you. And again, you have plenty of, you know, key levels there that are coming into play. And we did the big fib from that, you know, April low in 24 to this, but I also want to just look at the highs into the lows here. And now that is a third level. Okay. So we have the move from here to here. We drew fibs on, and that was one. Move from here to here, we drew fibs on, and that was one. Then we have the move from here to here, we drew fibs on, and it was so all we're saying. And then you have the 200 day coming into play. So there is a ton of resistance here, a lot of potential from the you know, technical aspect. So that's what we're looking at, folks. All right, there you have it. That's my chart of the day for Tesla. If you're here on Zacks.com, be sure to subscribe to the author so you get all of these videos as they're coming out. And if you're on YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube channel. For everybody else here at Zacks, I'm Dave Bartosiak, and I will catch you tomorrow.